everyone, and welcome to another newscast. My name is Sam Healey, and in this video, we're going to tell you all of the latest news about our projects, as well as the company. As always, if you don't want to watch the entire video, you can skip to the parts that interest you by utilizing the timestamps in the description below. Now, something new I'm going to start doing at the beginning of these videos is just listing the projects that we don't have any new information on for this week. That way, we'll hopefully convey that we haven't forgotten or overlooked anything, and that we're either still working on things on our end, or simply haven't received the information we requested yet. This week, we don't have any further information on Solomon Kane, Reichbusters Project Vril, or Hell the Last Saga. But without further ado, let's get to it. For Time of Legends Joan of Arc this week, as promised, we're going to share with you some of the new content of the Teutonic Knights scenarios, starting with some of the unit profile cards you unlocked as stretch goals during the campaign, beginning with the Great Furay. The Great Furay is a mighty warrior, although he is but a simple peasant. His true potential can only really shine once the battle has raged on for a while and both sides have suffered some casualties. According to the stories, this giant was killed while fighting, so don't hope for a comeback from the infirmary from him. Once upgraded, however, the towering Frenchman has some very impressive attack and health statistics. He doesn't offer much in the way of versatility, but his robust profile makes for a great frontline unit or even an effective skirmisher being able to work as a one-man unit. In his specific scenario, he must defend his village together with his friend Guillaume d'Alou, only aided by ordinary peasants against the raiding English forces. Having spearheaded a rebellious movement in Paris during the 100 Years' War, Etienne Marcel isn't much of a fighter, but makes up for it in his ability to assist the people through his command abilities and rally skills. He most likely won't be the most powerful choice when it comes to building armies, but his tool set will come in handy in his specific scenario, where he must stop the wyvern from rampaging through the streets with only his wits and the help of the local citizens. If you manage to upgrade him to level 2, however, you may be able to attack the beast head-on and bring it down. Just make sure not to leave him behind, as he would make for an easy target. Now, the following units all appear in the succubus scenario. The beggar's stench and appearance can push back enemy units, making for a contested civilian, as it can easily weaken a heavily reinforced enemy area. You can also initiate a discussion with him, netting all kinds of rewards and different effects, or to simply remove him from play. In the succubus scenario, special beggar discussion cards will also be used, hinting the heroes towards the evil that lurks below. And finally, here are the rat swarms. These come in numbers, and it shows. Their stats are pathetically weak, but the more rat swarms in an area, the more dice they roll. If you don't dispatch them while you have the occasion to do so, you could easily be overwhelmed with push and disrupted results, greatly hindering your army's abilities. Their numbers are key for the succubus to protect the entryways of her lair or to draw attention away from her as she hunts down her prey. For Super Fantasy Brawl this week, just a quick update on our scheduled tournament that begins this Saturday, November 28th. We've collected the emails of the first 42 registrants from our website, and from that, the first 32 will be receiving invitation emails by tomorrow. Once you receive your ticket slash invite, you'll need to go to the tournament website to register. If for any reason you won't be able to participate after having received the email invite, please let me know as soon as possible so that I can replace your ticket with one from the waiting list. As a reminder, matches will begin at 8 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time on Saturday, but we'll want you to show up about 30 minutes earlier so that we can make sure everyone is where they're supposed to be before the first round begins. So be on the lookout for those emails and make sure you respond as soon as they do show up. Just another short update for SteamWatchers this week, but some pretty cool stuff to show. We have received the resin masters from the factory. They finished the molds and produced some of the minis to see how they turned out. as you're looking at those bad boys, we also wanted to let you know that we finished up another level of proofreading in the French rulebook, and we're working on implementing those changes in the English version too. So things are progressing well. For Enchanters this week, we have been given the boat names that are en route to our three hubs. Headed for our North American hub at Quartermaster Logistics is the 1Honolulu/210E, as in Edward. On the way to our European hub at Meeple Logistics is the Thalassa Manna 0524-033W. And headed towards our Oceania hub at VR Distribution, the OOCL Texas /176S, as in Sam, is powering through. And that's all we have for you right now. And finally, for Darkest Dungeon, the board game this week, with the Kickstarter campaign over, development is back to being our focus. And last week, that focus centered on the rooms. Currently, the design of all general rooms for the core box and all expansions is complete. This is a first pass, of course, and through playtesting, things might need tweaking here and there. As you know, rooms are one of the unique elements to the board game. Instead of having a grid with random stuff spawning on rooms, we wanted to give personal attention to each individual room. In order for each room to feel unique, we handcrafted a story behind them, a theme, if you like. Where the heroes start, what hazards are in each room, what boons where each loot chest is, all are taken into consideration to create a unique challenge each time you start a battle. Add to that random enemy spawns, and you get what we hope is a huge variety of combat encounters that will have you talking about it when it's all said and done. The art contributes towards this vision too. Instead of reusing generic assets in all rooms, we have them hand-drawn over the basic design. This way, the two actions to loot the treasure in the treasure chamber is visually transformed into a trap door hidden under the rug, and the plus one stress if you end your turn here, or minus one stress if you end your turn there, of the Path of Light room are transformed to dark, web-infested corridors with a sunbeam breaking through cracks in the wall. Each expansion has a different theme, and this is also reflected in the rooms and their theme too. The ruins are full of treacherous corridors and ritual chambers that will test the resolve of the heroes. In the cove, more loot can be found, but you'll have to traverse through flooded caves that present no problems to the pelagic creatures living there. The ruins of the courtyard lie in a treacherous swamp infested with poisonous waters and plague-spreading insects. When you suffer, your foes are strengthened. The thick woods of the Weald will have you spread all over the place, lost, while necrotic fungi will prevent your healing skills. And in the Warrens, guarded by the swine, the rewards are higher, but so is the risk. Now, you might notice that we said that the general rooms are done. This does not include the boss encounter rooms. Bosses have their own unique rooms and special rules, so they need special attention. But this is a tale for another Wednesday. Until then, keep your torches lit and your wounds closed. Now, we also wanted to remind you that we will be running some Black Friday deals in our eShop this weekend on Friday, November 27th through Monday, November 30th. So be sure to stop by mythicgames.net and check those out. Remember that Leo will be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. GMT, 1 p.m. Eastern Time on our YouTube channel with a live Q&A in English, and at 8:30 p.m. Paris time with a live Q&A in French. So tune in if you have any questions or just to see what he might spoil. But that's it for this week. Stay home, stay safe, play some games while you're at it, and we'll see you on the flip side. Take care.